After some time off from moving states, I'm finally back to working on the remake of Fable and Unreal Engine 5 as a minimum viable product that consists of the first hour of the game at the very least. Just a reminder for this, I'm making the map fully loadless, remaking and improving all the systems, and adding custom features and gameplay moments. Now let's get into the updates. At the end of the last episode, I talked about possible solutions for getting outfits into the game, and also mentioned that it seems I could just copy the bone transform of the hero to the bones of the outfit. This actually had a lot of challenges to work around with. First off, I created an outfit and attachable manager that allows me to set an engine and during play mode which outfit or objects should be attached to the hero. The system allows for pants, gloves, hair, beards, hats, masks, and all other clothing type. This was simple enough, but the problem started with the fact that the attachments following the bones they are attached to were always one frame behind. I tried using delegates after the animation frame had updated, looking into delays, and even tried finding a way to edit the execution order of everything, which is a really cool thing that you can do in Unity really easily. None of the current solutions worked, and I actually ended up spending a really long time trying to figure out how to resolve this. However, I finally figured out the issue and got it working. Almost. There are still a few weird spots where the skin is seen through the outfit, but I need to move on to other features after having spent about 2 weeks on this one thing alone. At this point, I wanted to see if I can improve the frame rate of the project, so I activated a new system exclusive to Unreal Engine 5 called Nanite on all the meshes in Oakvale. If you don't know, Nanite is a new tool on UE5 that is basically an automatic LOD system. LODs, or level of detail, is a system where you can move further away from an object's mesh, the quality level will drop to save resources and eventually be called out. And calling is basically just when an object is no longer being rendered. Well, Nanite looks to replace that by lowering the quality of the object based on how visible it is to the user. This basically means that as I move further away from object, it appears to stay at the highest quality, but it's actually perfectly scaling back fidelity-wise with the pixels making up the object. This system could be a game changer as it is very efficient and could save a lot of time for artists not having to mainly make LOD levels themselves. This could become an industry standard practice with all 3D game engines within the next 5 years. It also preserves shadows, which cannot be said for the lowest quality LODs usually. Anyway, I set up every static mesh with Nanite and it is improving my frame rate substantially. I didn't add Nanite to the foliage as that can only be done in Unreal Engine 5.1, which I did download and port the project to. However, I couldn't make a build and the project was having a few issues in 5.1, so I'm sticking with 5.0 for now at least. Now many viewers may have seen the video I made where I added the Chamber of Fate to the project. Well, this is when that happened, and if you want a detailed explanation of how I'm getting these regions in Unreal Engine 5, you can check that video in the description. In short though, I exported the meshes and materials from Fable, imported them into my remake, set up the materials, connected the chamber to the connecting bridge, and added lights to the region. I also started adding a path to connect the region to the library of the guild. I'm just making a crude layout to which I can get an actual model made to fit the path better. Then I can officially connect those two once the level loader is in, but I have to wait since as you can see, the cave is so tall it protrudes to the ground. Then I began work on AI behavior trees, starting with beetles. Then I converted the chicken behavior from being scripted to using the behavior tree. Let me just interject here real quick with how difficult it is to find a good quality video showing how to use the behavior trees. It seems like all the tutorials use a basic stealth system for behavior in their example. While AI and stealth games can be extremely complicated, it is also the genre that can have by far some of the simplest AI in game development. There are a few other genres that can have even more simple AI, but bad AI is common on these cheap stealth games on Steam. I got it figured out, but there is definitely a gap in educational content on this subject. We really need a game dev YouTube channel that does tutorials on Unreal that are as higher quality as the tutorial by GameMaker's Toolkit for Unity. Anyway, let's get back on topic. Or off topic really, because at this point I stopped working on the project temporarily to begin making a speedrun randomizer. I'll make this pretty quick, but I still want to explain it for those interested. Basically, I have speedrun the game New Super Lucky's Tale, and I'm in the speedrun community for the game. Well, the others in the group reached out to me to ask if it would be possible to make a randomizer for the game. So that is currently in progress right now, as well as other game modes for the game. I'll probably make a random video showing how I'm doing this by editing the source code, but it's a much smaller project than Fable. Finally, I started work on the HUD UI. I added in the ability and item bar, but they don't really have any functionality right now. However, I also added the health and mana bar and tied those bars to the values. So if I lose health, the bar will go down. I also created the main menu for this project. I used the menu plugin to get the base functionality working quickly, but actually updated a lot of the art style. I had started to use the book menu from Fable Anniversary, but I booted up the original Lost Chapters version on my 360 recently. I forgot how much better the art looked on that version compared to the remaster. Just to note, I do want to thank the Fable historian for getting me access to the art for the menu. Using the assets collected by this creator, I was able to use the high quality versions of the key art from the game as well as some concept art. I'm pretty happy with how this looks for sure. Now what is next exactly for this project? I really need to get in some audio soon, but I'm still going to hold off on that for now. I also need to start getting some actual gameplay in soon. So while that may not be combat necessarily, there are plenty of other gameplay mechanics for me to bring in. Maybe I could start with some super simple NPCs and work on the mission and dialogue system. It'd be neat if I could make it to where you could actually go through the Oakville quest line. Also, I'll try not to take so much time off between videos for my next update. After having moved into the house, we're doing tons of renovations here, and even my AWS account was hacked where I keep my server for my Steam game. Anyways, that's all for this update now, and y'all take care now.